So I just bought a 32 gigs of pen drive. And until I insert it into my computer, I realized they lied to me. So where are my 2.8 gigs of memory? Let's talk about KiloByte versus KibiByte.
The Greeks use many terms like kilo for a thousand. First, some YouTuber has 5.7k subs, mega for a million, giga for a billion, tera for a trillion, and peta for a quadrillion. Consequently, because Greeks were very familiar with these phrases, many scientists went with this convention. This is what we call SI system or base 10 system. But when the computer revolution started, the people back then didn't went with the base 10 scientific convention and rather went with the fact that most memory architectures uses sizes that are in power of 2 or base 2. That's why the memory drives we buy today goes like 2, 4, 8, 16, 32 and so on. So binary computing behavior of computers left computer scientists those days to use the base 2 system. And the difference was only 24 bytes, so maybe they thought, why not call it a kilo? Many companies took advantage of this confusion cleverly to sell users with lesser storage. So in the year 1975 AD, the 8-inch DEC RX-01 floppy disk, which was advertised as 256K, people usually called kilobytes with just K. For example, the Macintosh 128K, it had 128KB of RAM. So the DEC RX-01 floppy disk, which was advertised at 256KB, actually only had 256,256 bytes. So if you just divide it by 1024, it is 250.25 KB. After that, the popularity of using base 10 system on storage uprose like crazy, because many companies were benefiting from this. So in December 1998, IEC, International Electrotechnical Commission, settled this confusion by suggesting prefixes like KiB, MiB, GiB, etc. And later in the paper IEC 80013, which was published in 2008, strictly standardized the terms KibiByte to mean 1024 bytes and KiloByte to mean 1000 bytes. After that, companies are recognizing these terms like KB to refer to 1000 bytes, well, sort of, but and provided the old KB with the new name KibiByte. So why KiB? The KI, which is the two letter from the word kilo, and BI, which is the two letter from the word binary, they combine those words to form the words like KiB, MiB, GiB. Now the old system was changed. KibiByte meant 1024 byte, MiBByte meant 1024 KibiByte, GiBByte meant 1024 MiBByte, and so on. So many started using the term kilobyte to refer to 1000 bytes and KibiByte to refer to 1024 bytes. Similarly, in December 2002, JEDEC standardized base 2 system for semiconductor industry. This is why still to this day, random access memory manufacturers still use the base 2 system. In my case, my 16GB RAM is shown as 15.8GB or GibiByte. The 0.2GB of RAM is reserved by the system. The other main memory manufacturers using the base 10 system was kind of confusing for the end user, and don't get me started with all the lawsuits. Most people use the Windows operating system, which still to this day refuses to use the base 10 system, while macOS has moved on from binary to decimal. This is why your file sizes are larger on the macOS than on your Windows. And when people buy storage devices, it is when people kind of feel scammed. This was not much of a problem when people were talking about kilobytes and megabytes. But the difference is because the difference is considerable. For example, if you went to buy a thumb drive with 1 KB of storage, it will show 0.97 KIB or KB if you are on Windows. Approximately, the difference is 2.3%. The difference just doubles every time you go from kilobyte to megabyte to gigabyte, etc. This is an article from the official page of IEC, and let me read it. Have you ever wondered why your 500 GB hard drive only has about 488 gigabytes once it has been formatted? What does 400 gigabytes mean here? If my math is correct, the approximate difference between the base 10 system to base 2 system in gigabytes is about 6.9%. Nice. A simple Google search tells us that 500 GB from decimal is about 465.5 GB in binary. IEC, please get your math correct. You all were the people behind all these terms. This is the table that shows the difference, which is an approximation to a point, but still it's better than IEC. On your right is the table you should focus on if you are used to the binary system. For example, if you buy 1 terabyte of hard drive, you will actually have about 931 GB of storage. The difference is staggeringly 9.1%. Even though this is mathematically correct, you can't actually use 931 gigabytes of storage. If you multiply my pen drive, which is 32 GB, I should have 32 billion bytes, billion with the B. But actually, my pen drive only has about 31.44 billion bytes. The exact number will be shown on the screen, but still, some bytes are missing. So where is my 558 MBs of storage?
Because you also need to format the volume before it's useful. Formatting just means creating a new empty file system, and file systems are also bytes stored on the same disk. There is structure involved, tables to keep track of file locations and free blocks, etc. Creating those structures even when there is no data to put in them is still writing bytes to the disk. That is why my 558 MB of storage was hidden on the Windows.
Thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, and dislike if you dislike the video. But be sure to type out some feedbacks in the comment below. This video was inspired from YouTube channels like Mac Address, Tom Scott, Veritasium, Vsauce, etc. And all the sources and coordinates of this place will be in the description below. And goodbye.